never, never gonna give it. I'm singing, girl. Name, no stop. Feel about you, girl. I just can't think about you. Never, never, never gonna quit. Quit, this ain't my shit, girl. Sing it to status, girl. Ew.
Whatever you want.
Girl.
Girl, you got. Sing it, baby.
Sing it, Sister B, girl, sing it. Real, I have what the world is searching for. Dear, my dear, ew. No more. Pray. Was like you to make me feel the way I do. I'm never, never gonna give up. I will never stop. Oh, the way I feel about you, girl, I just can't live without you. I'm never gonna quit. Sing it, girl, quit just ain't my shit. Yes, girl. Sing it, Mrs. Duffy, honey. Yes, baby. I'm never, never gonna give up. I'm never, never gonna stop. Other than looking about you, girl, I just can't live without you. I'm never, never gonna quit. Quitting ain't my shit. Yes, baby. Give me a second, you all. Let me sit down, honey. Uh-oh, wait. Oh, we ain't ready for you yet, baby. Hold on now. Wait. All right. Hey, you all. Sister Patsy, get in the camera, honey. Get in the camera, honey. Hey, you all, it's Bimbo One, how's Walker Walker Ew? And Sister Patterson here is late like Barry White, honey. That's right, girl. Your hair is late like Barry White, honey. Circa 1980. Girl, fix your wig, girl. Hold on. Oh, God. Okay, I'm trying to give her Barry White. Shout out to all my old school, okay? You youngins don't know, okay? I do a lot of old school on the show, honey, because I just can't get into this, you know, this new music, honey. But, yes. So, you know, I took me a little shower today, you know, wash this ass, wash this dick, honey, wash these underarms. So, you know, I have my music blasting. So, you know, I'm singing in the shower. Like, I sings in the shower. Who don't sing in the shower? So, I got my Barry White, my Barbara Mason, my Betty White going, because you know I'm an old school cat. And this song came on. I'm never gonna give it up. So, you know, I'm in the shower, you know, washing my ass. I'm like, who in there singing? Sister Patterson here. Bitch, I'm like, bitch, what you know about that? She was like, what you know about that? I was like, bitch, I'm playing it. So I was like, you know what? We gonna start the show off like that. I want you to wear the Barry White wig. Yes, Barry hair used to be late, like, I don't know. So shout out to Barry White and shout out to Funky Diva. Sister Patterson hair is late like Barry White, honey. And rest in peace, Barry White, honey. I used to love that old soul. I used to, you know what? I always wanted to have phone sex with him. Imagine having phone sex with Barry White, that old sexy voice. Y'all, what you doing, baby? Take them panties off. Take them motherfucking panties off, baby. Oh, but anyway, shout out to all you youngins. That is Barry White, never gonna give you up. If you wanna download that, that's some good. Baby, you was born to that music. I was probably born to that, baby. But I do my research. Like, I just can't. Like, I really wish I was this age during that time. Like, that was my music. Like, I really wish I was, like, I grew up in the wrong era, baby, because that's that music, that's that making love, baby. I wouldn't be here, honey, if it wasn't for songs like that, baby, okay? Imagine your mother making love to some Rihanna. Cake. Well, no, baby, I need some songs that's gonna make you get into the mood, make you take them panties off, honey, okay? I don't care if it's your time under my bitch. Let me get some of that pussy, honey. And, so yeah, you all checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. And I want to speak on some of the supporter comments from my video from yesterday. someone said Usher wifey, 3210. She goes, I'm sorry, Bimbo, but I'm gonna have to disagree with you. Some black / Spanish girls can suck some good dick. Speaking for myself, I'm damn good. LOL, happy birthday. Now look here, Usher wifey, bitch. I never said girls and women can't suck dick, honey, okay? I said gay men and drag queens and trannies are the best dick suckers, honey, okay? I never said nobody can suck a good dick. We all suck dick, bitch, but there has to be a best. So what I meant by that was gay men and trannies and, you know, just men, period, we are the Beyoncés of dick sucking, honey, okay? Don't get me wrong, you can suck a dick, but understand something, bitch, you are Ashanti and you Ciara, bitch, okay? When it comes to dick sucking, bitch, I'm the motherfucking Beyoncé, bitch, okay? I runs this motherfucking shit, bitch, okay? Don't get me wrong, you can suck a good dick there and there, you got a few people gonna support you, bitch, but they all support this ass when it comes to sucking dick, bitch, okay? Can you deep throw the 16-inch, bitch? Try it, bitch. Try it, you can, bitch, okay? So sit your Ashanti ass down, bitch, but thank you for the comment. But like I said again, yeah, I'm sorry, Sister Patterson, you all, I know you suck a good dick, I suck a butt, bitch, when it comes down to it, okay? Give me a contest, the best dick sucker. See how quick you can make a nigga come. That's to us trannies and drag queens, and we suck a good dick, honey. Because, first of all, it's like a fantasy for some of these straight men. I stress that straight men, right, to be with a tranny or a drag queen. So it's not your normal girl. So it's like more of a fantasy. It's more of a turn on. So their dick is extra hard. They want to come like, oh. So whatever. I mean, to each his own. If you feel like you can suck a good dick, don't let my messy ass take it away from you, honey. Suck dick, suck it right, bitch, okay? But anyway, my hair is laid like a football player or a basketball player. Yo, I love Funky Diva, man. Like, I don't do these other YouTubers. They're boring. I don't do none of B-Scott. They all, Waka Waka New. But Funky Diva, baby, you, like, if I can watch your show, you better work, bitch. I don't do too many. I don't do none. I do, baby, him, my other baby on, you know, who you are, Twitter, Bijon. I do, what's this, Young Gotti, Vicky Gotti, certain people, the Scorpion, but it, the rest of you, sit down, okay, this is not your calling, baby, okay, find something else to do, baby, you're boring, you know, I'm not like the hot shit, but, you know, okay, but, so, my hair is laid like a YouTuber, yo, y'all gotta, Google him, Funky Diva, you better work, baby, anyway, so, what did I want? Oh, so I understand a lot of you all out there want to become big. It's Sister Patterson, bitch. I feel like you too far away, bitch. Okay, you did too much work today, bitch. Be over there, honey. Okay, bring your ass over here, honey. Wait, we can't see you. All right, stay over there. All right. Her hair is late, like or somebody. Listen to me. Yes, on a serious note, a lot of you all want to become singers and actors and all these big time celebs and famous, and you all come to me asking me, you know, Bimba, how can I become famous? How can I get famous? Da da. I ain't nobody's star. I'm broke, living on my mother's couch. Who's about to move to Ohio? So I ain't gonna know what's gonna happen, but you know. But I mean, I am known. Like, quite a few people know me through this mess, and you all come to me asking me, how can I get myself out there? How can I become this YouTube star or whatever? Baby, get to these nibbles, honey. I'll get into these babies, honey. Come suck these babies. I told you all back in high school, I used to be so embarrassed, but I wish I was the person I am today, baby. I would have had my motherfucking titties all out walking around that whole motherfucking locker room. Like, what, nigga? Suck these Oh, I love these nibbles. I have, like, the sexiest nibbles. But, a lot of you all asking me, you know, how can I... Let me tell you something. The number one rule is to be your motherfucking self. That's where a lot of people fell at. They don't be themselves. They look at others and how others made it, and they want to follow them or beat them. You all have to be yourself. Stop trying to follow someone else when that's not you. That person is good at doing that because that's who they are. The reason you fail is because you're trying to be that, but that's not who you are naturally. You know what I'm saying? Another step is a lot of you rappers and singers and female singers, we can't relate to you. Like, I know this one girl, you know, she's trying to become a singer, This is passing you guys. This chick, I got Prada, Gucci. I got the flyest car. Da da da. Bitch, you live in the projects, honey, okay? I'm not gonna spill so much of your tea, but honey, you ain't driving, bitch. You take the bus, bitch, okay? You take the 2 train, bitch. Fuck you talking about you driving this, bitch. People can't relate to you, honey. That's why you're failing. This is why you have not got put on yet, honey, okay? If you're gonna pretend, at least have something to back it up, bitch. All you doing is talking about it, bitch. We don't see it. That's where a lot of you all fail at. You're trying to be something that you're not. A lot of you rapping dudes talking about, oh, I bust my gun, I kill a cat, da da da. You ain't never touched a gun a day in your life. Hell, you ain't never seen a gun. Talk about you killing somebody. You ain't killing nobody, honey, okay? So, people gotta relate to you, okay? A lot of people relate to me because I'm gonna let you know, I sucked a dick for $20 last week. I sleep on my mother's couch. I'm broke living in the hood. People can relate to this. When people cannot relate to you, they don't support it. You know what I mean? That's the first step on trying to get your name out there. You have to be real about your situation. Trust me, there's someone like going through something that I'm going. We all are stressed out. We all think about committing suicide. We all think about this. We all think about that. I try to give you my authentic self because a lot of people out here, they are fakes. They're not giving who they truly are, honey. And that's something I don't support. So why, you know, a lot of people support me is because Bimbo is real. Bimbo's going to give it to you the way you see it, honey. The way you see it, you're gonna see me in a laundromat. Just like I come on here and talk about I'm in the laundromat, you're gonna see me in a laundromat. Just like the way, whatever. That's like the golden rule, or trying to become whatever you're trying to do. If you're trying to be an actor, TV, you need to be your authentic self, honey. People don't like a fake. And sadly, a lot of fakes made it, but they got lucky, okay? They got lucky because they probably was sexy, suck somebody dick that put them on, or whatever the case may be. And you also have to work hard. I've been doing this YouTube shit for almost 4 years, 5 years now. It has not gotten me nowhere, but a lot of people know me. You know what I'm saying? I have got quite a few parties, and I got paid for doing parties. Quite a few things happen for me, but I'm not where I'm want to be, but I'm going to continue to grind. You also have to continue to grind. You just got to stay focused on what you want to do, honey, okay? You can't be trying to do a million things. You have to have your eyes on one prize and what it is that you're trying to do. And you can't be like everything else that's out here. There's nothing like this on YouTube. Don't get me wrong, you got Gay Boys, you got the Scorpion, you got B Scott and all these, but I guarantee these motherfuckers not going to come on YouTube and tell you they suck the dick for $20, honey, okay? They're not going to tell you that they live on their mother couch. They're not going to tell you this. Bimbo is not like nothing else. And that's another thing. You may copy some people. Like people said, oh, Nicki Minaj copied Little Kim. That's how she got famous. Yes, she slightly copied Kim. But the trick is, when you copy someone, you have to remix the whole situation and make it your own. That's why I support Nicki. This is why I applaud her. Because she switched. But my thing is, Kim, who can't wear a red wig? Why when somebody put a red or green wig, bitch, you think they're trying to be you, bitch? When somebody want to walk around with their titty out, bitch, ain't nobody trying to be you, Kim. But we're not going to get into that. I'm just saying, you could take someone's style because you looked up to that person. Their person was your idol. Like people say, like I remind them on Wendy Williams. But the thing is, Wendy is not going to reveal to you that, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to give you my all, honey. I'm not trying to be nobody but Bimbo. Back on Kim and the whole Nicki thing, you all can say, oh, she copied Kim. I have yet to hear Nicki say she stuffed a dick in her pussy, or she sucked the dick. She used to be scared of the shit. Now she throw lips to the shit. Like, she slightly took Kim's down, which was very apparent. But she remixed it and she made it her own. And at this point, she's bigger than Kim. So that's the truth, baby. So you all can say what you want. You can take somebody's style, but remix it. Because I look up to Wendy. I look up to Charlamagne. I look up to Howard Stern. I look to Oprah. I look up to Tyler Perry. But you see a little of them, I mean, but it's not 100%. You may see like 10% of Charlamagne. You may see 40% of Wendy and me. But at the end of the day, I am Bimbo. So my advice to everyone that should be trying to come famous or be known or whatever, you have to be yourself. Stop lying to these people when you don't have... You don't have the backup. Yes, a lot of these rapper dudes, they talk about busting guns, you working at a job, paying your child support, you ain't hurting nobody, okay? That's what you need to rhyme about. Yo, I'm struggling, working, trying to pay my child support. You know how many niggas is going through that, getting half of their check taken out to pay child support? Talk about that. Stuff that people can relate to. We don't always want to hear, I'm killing somebody, I'm shooting up, pop up, shout out to all my goons. That's like so late and so tired at this point. And the reason why Lil Wayne is so huge, Lil Wayne is different. I find him corny, but I applaud him for being who he is, and he's at the top of his game because he's different. He's out here every song, I'm shooting, I'm killing. He's different, and that's another thing. You will have to be different. You cannot be like everything else, because if you be like everything else, everyone's gonna look at you like that's just the same old situation. Okay, with Bimbo, you could put me in a line of 100 gay dudes. The only one that's gonna stand out is Juan. Believe that. So think about it. If you're totally trying to be famous, you really have to think about, like I said, the number one step is just being your fucking self, honey. That's it. Being you. We spent 18 minutes all that. I should got paid for that, honey, because that's the truth, honey. That's the truth, honey, coming from someone. Babe, look at these nipples, honey. Get into these nipples, baby. All right, listen, you guys. What are we talking about? You all wanted me to talk about this whole Beyonce picture and Sandra Rose. You guys know I love Sandra Rose. You ain't got no alibi, Sandra, because you ugly, honey. So Sandra Rose posted to Twitter. She posted on her blog yesterday. She put something around the words, Blue Ivory, that's Beyonce's daughter, has her mother's salon channel on, which she does. Here's a picture of it too. Yes. Very much so. So anyway, this is what Sandra Rose had to say. She said, last night, in my head, I was praying and I asked the Lord to comfort and heal the crazed Beyonce stans who flooded my email box with such hatred and threats upon my life for voicing my opinion. Yesterday, I posted the viral pictures of Beyonce's daughter, Blue Ivory, with a headline that read, Blue Ivory has her mother's salon chair line. Everyone except the Beyonce stans knows that Beyonce did not give birth to her daughter, Blue Ivory Carter. That doesn't mean she isn't a good mother. Industry insiders whisper that Beyonce's sister Solange donated her eggs so a surrogate mother could carry Beyonce's baby to term. Beyonce's husband Jay-Z has gone on record to say that Beyonce has had miscarriages in the past and she was infertile as a result, meaning that Beyonce can't have kids. Someone else wrote, sorry that you're receiving such hate mail, Sandra. You're a great blogger and you're very informative. Blah, blah, blah. So, I don't know. Looking at that picture, I do believe that Solange helped Beyonce and that whole little situation. I'm sorry, you all. I truly believe that Beyonce did not give birth to that baby. Because I just look at Mariah Carey, I look at the Jennifer Lopez, the Halle Berry's. They gave so much more to their birth, to their first seed, to their birth twins, you know, a couple of mad twins. Beyonce didn't give me that much. It was like she was trying to keep it hidden. To me, when it's your first birth and you're a celeb, you know, you got all these fans, you're going to have every chance to show off your stomach. We got maybe two pictures out of that. And I'm thinking Beyonce just ate a lot and got fat. And then she lost the weight so quick. It was like she gave birth and a month later, she's back to average size. It was like, can you take this trip, like whatever she had, I don't know. It's just I find it all weird. Do you all, like, I don't want to get on top this topic again, but do you all believe that Beyonce gave birth to that child? Whatever. To me, she's a good mother, and that's what a child needs in their life. It's not who gave birth to the child, it's how the child is raised, and if that mother is a good mother. And to me, Beyonce is a good mother, and plus she's rich, so that baby don't care who mother, you know, whoever my mommy is, I don't care, my mommy's rich, honey, okay? That's all that matters at the end of the day. But I do believe Solange helped in Beyonce having her little pregnancy. Anyway, moving on, so I know you all love Love & Hip Hop Atlanta. I do not watch these shows. But anyway, a lot of people are saying that this show is scripted. That, you know, what's the guy's name? I don't know. Whatever the people's names is, Jocelyn and all of them and Steven, they're all being scripted as to what to say. Well, Mona Scott was on DJ Sway MTV's Rap Fix Live, and she goes, these people have every right to tell their stories. I think they're valid stories. And judging by the numbers, they're stories that people want to see and hear.
but this is not your cup of tea. Basically, she's saying that the show's not scripted, and you guys know I don't watch this Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. I need to, but I just can't. Like, it just, if it's gonna be a scripted show, make it a real show. Stop trying to make it seem like it's reality. Like, if you're gonna give us a scripted show, let us know it's what it is. Stop trying to make it seem like anyway, someone on Rhymes with Snitch said it. She said Mona is telling the truth. It's not scripted. What they do in reality, TV is that they tell the people, you see a screen on a situation and have them react. They ask questions and feed them info. All the scenes are highly set up. There may not be a script, but the producers highly influence what's going on. So Mona is full of shit. Baby Mona, okay, honey, she's a producer. She ain't gotta reveal nothing about her life, okay? She's just a top bitch. She gave these little ghetto people a show. Hey, you wanna go out there, do what you do, honey? I'm gonna produce this. She's making more than these motherfuckers, little do they know. But baby, I do reality TV. If you want, I don't care, bitch. You want me to do reality TV? I don't give a fuck, bitch. Okay, I put myself out there, okay? I have no problem. But understand something. Bimbo reality show is gonna be a real show. I don't want no scripted nothing, okay? What you gonna see is what you gonna get. You gonna see me going on that 2 train, going down the blocks, sucking dick, and dudes trying to hate me, love me, like these two Jamaican guys gonna throw a cup at me the other day. I was walking home there 241st. I don't say nothing. Like, I don't respond to no. You can scream, diss me, Bati boy, Chichima, that's a man. You will never get a response from me. I would just stare at you. I don't respond to nobody, okay? I only respond to love. I just talk about you on the show. I don't respond, so I guess they wanted a response out of me because they was taking pictures. So I started cheesing. So, they circled the block, and I just ignored him. So when I got to the corner, he throws like an iced tea or whatever he had, orange juice, because it was in the morning. I turned around, it didn't hit me, but I did take down a license plate. Like, little do they know, I was like, when I'm doing stuff, I'm watching you. Be cautious of people who don't say nothing. We're watching because I had your license plates. I had the color, like, stupid, I was slightly recording you. You didn't notice, but I don't say nothing. But anyway, Bimbo needs a reality show. Anyway, moving on. Willow Smith, where's the story at? Willow Smith, Rhymes with Snitches is reporting that Will and Jada are heads over heels with Willow. Rumors are swirling that Will and Jada are at odds over the way Willow is being raised. Sources tell Star Magazine, Willow has been acting out like crazy over the past few months, pulling all sorts of attention, stunts like dyeing her hair green, getting a fake Tom Pants, and ratting on Twitter. Will is fed up. He is all for expression, but Danks is too much too soon. Jada Danks Willow is a brilliant budding artist, and she's doing everything in her power to push Willow's showbiz career like a crazy stage mom. The Star source insists that Will is very private and is mortified that Jada encouraged Willow to share her innermost thoughts on social networking sites, and adds Will is worried about a public meltdown. I have no comment. Like, I have no comment. I thought with my hair back and forth was a cute, you know, little song, whatever. She got a little money off of that. But I think she was rushing to it too soon. You know, having your parents as Will and Jada, they should have really sat down with this girl. I just think it's not enough attention on this young lady. I honestly think that when, take it for someone like me, who never had a good relationship with my mother, and I still don't. Sometimes you look to internet, you look to Facebook, you look to Twitter for comfort. It's not attention. You just want someone to talk to. So I honestly think that Jada and Will don't have a good relationship with their daughter. That's why she's doing it. If she had a good, prominent relationship with her parents, she wouldn't be putting herself. How do you not realize your daughter just dyed her hair green? How do you not realize your daughter just, you know, got a fake tongue piercing? I don't know. Like I said, it's all up to you guys. What do you all think? They do need to have a sit down with their daughter and say, mommy, rushing it, give it some time, because by 20 years old, no one's gonna care. Look at all these child stars. Only one that really made it was Raven Simone, but a lot of these child stars No one cares about no more. Like, Urkel, no one cares about you. You know, because you was this child star. Look at all them little hoes who's on Full House. Them little DJs. And where are these bitches at? Tiana from the Will Smith show. You just have to plan it out correctly. You know what I'm saying? Like, understand something, baby. Okay, you hot now, but 10 years from now, no one's going to care, baby. But I don't know. What do you all think? Moving on. So, Kim K, I cannot stand Kim Kardashian. I just don't like this bitch. I don't know. It's just, I just don't like her. Anyway, she went on her Twitter page yesterday. She tweeted, "You wouldn't be who you are today. You wouldn't have the depth, maturity, and the insight were it not for the challenges that forced you to grow." She also said, "Keep your life positive perspective. We are not defined by our past." So, the guy who helped her get rich and famous, Ray J, tweeted three little letters, LOL. Exactly. I will respect him if she would glorify the fact that, bitch, you are where you at because you was sucking dick on the motherfucking camera. You know how many bitches suck dick on camera to get to your spot, and the fact that you can't even fucking glorify? Like, I respect Superhead because Superhead wrote a book about it. She let you know about all these dicks she sucked, and she still talk about it to this day. Kim Kardashian tries to put all that in the past. Like, bitch, you didn't get to this motherfucking spot for sucking a fat, black dick. Ray J looked like he about 9 inches. It wasn't that big, Ray J. But, a lot of people don't like this girl. She's like a manipulator, and she's a liar to me. I don't know. I just never liked her. I hate the way she talked. It's something about Kim K that I feel is very fake. You know what I'm saying? Like, the fact that, bitch, you sucked a big, black, fat dick on camera that sold millions, honey, and you're where you are at this point, and you're trying to, like, glorify this is not how you got famous, bitch. You can't forget about the past, because the past helped you get to your motherfucking present. Your present will help you get to your future, bitch. But you won't be in any future if you couldn't be about your past, bitch. So don't sit up here and try to make this thing like, oh, I got it. Bitch, what have you done? You have not done nothing, bitch. You ain't put no albums out. You ain't been no motherfucking actor, bitch. You ain't do nothing, bitch, respectable, but suck the dick. There's a lot of bitches who will admit, I suck the dick, if they was in your position. This is how I got here. But, bitch, I can't support Kim. I never did, never will. I just can't connect to this bitch. Like how I said in the beginning of this video, you have to have people connect to you. I can't connect to this bitch. I'm sorry, you all. I'm sorry to all you Kim K fans, but this bitch just don't do it for me. I'm sorry. So I'm glad that Ray J put LOL. He should have went on that bitch. Like, bitch, are you serious? You said my dick. Now you with Kanye. Thank you the shit, bitch. And I really don't like the fact that she was at the BET Awards sitting there like she was on my fucking Hollywood and on my fucking Diana fucking Princess Diana, bitch. When you got here by sucking a black dick, bitch, okay? You ain't put no motherfucking music out. Let this space be for people who has really done something with their motherfucking self. They worked hard. They knew how it was to fucking really struggle to try to get where they need to be in fucking life, bitch. All you did was suck a motherfucking dick, and now you think you the motherfucker. I don't like her. I'm sorry. I don't fucking do Kim. I would never do her. I would never like her until this bitch can admit, like, I got to this space by sucking a dick. That's all I need for you to say, bitch. A lot of people like me will support you more if we hear them words. Like, on top of the supporters that you have now, bitch, you will bring a lot more supporters if you would make that motherfucking statement. I got where I got by sucking a dick, Ray J dick. You my bitch. But until then, bitch, fuck you, bitch. Moving on. I want to shout out to a chick that I do love, Keisha Cole. So Keisha Cole has this new single out, and her album is slated to drop sometime in November. Bitch, why are we waiting so long for this album? Anyway, her new single is called, what's the new single called? It's with Lil Wayne. Give me a second, you all. It's called Enough or No Love. And baby, I don't know what Keisha was doing with these little past three albums. I don't know if she was just lazy or what, but I heard a few of these tracks off this album, and let me tell you something. That Keisha Cole that we loved, that we came, it's back, honey. Anyway, her new single is called Enough or No Love. I'm going to get into that track, but right now, before we get into that, I just want to count down my top favorite Keisha Cole songs of all time. Wait a minute. Listen, we're going to go into the intro. And then when I be back, I'm going to count down my top favorite Keisha Cole songs of all time. Plus, I'm going to review this new song with Lil Wayne. And then I have a few emails. You're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. And look at my nose. Look at my nose. All I need is, like, I sweat a lot. So, I got my AC on now. So, I'm in here recording these shows. I just don't have the AC on.
Sister Battles, you all right? You all back there, bitch? Okay. Her hair is laying like, Barry White.
All right, you all. I'll be right back. We're going to count down my top favorite Keisha Cole songs of all time. And some other stuff. So, you're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. Waka, waka.
Listen, this is what I told you, bitch. Okay? On the dance floor, I don't give a fuck. I'ma take that dick and take it in my butt. I got a juicy ass and a big ass cock. Yeah, know this queen, I just won't stop. I'm not covering, but I get super head. I'ma choke on that dick until I'm dead. I'm a nasty hoe, I'm a nasty bitch. Come on, Sister P, it's that addiction shit, you know?
Well, fuck you too. Fuck you too. I'm sorry, you guys. We're back, and Sister Patterson left. Uh-oh, my nose. Uh-oh, don't do this. I'm with the whole show without my nose acting up. I'm on nose alert today, baby, because, baby. Sister Battison left because I pulled her wig off. I just don't understand females who get mad when you pull their wig off. Bitch, we know that's a wig, bitch. That ain't your real hair, so why you get mad with your... Whatever. Boss, I could do the rest of the show without you, bitch. Whatever. Anyway, like I said, we're going to count down my top five favorite Keisha Cole songs of all time. Alright, let's get into it. Here's number five, you guys. This is, wait. This is I Remember. I know you all know I Remember. This is my number five favorite. Listen, Keisha Cole, you got a lot of songs, honey. Too many songs. But I had to really dig down in the crates and figure out my top five favorite songs, honey. Here's number five. This is I Remember, honey. You all know this. Ooh, I remember. Don't forget Keisha Cole new album, Woman to Woman, is coming real soon. Where are you? But we must do, baby. Keisha wouldn't be where she at if it wasn't for the past, honey. Where are you? When I need it, night, thinking of, could sleep without you, didn't know. All the time we share. Alright, that's number five. That was I Remember. Alright, number four. My number four favorite Keisha Cole song of all motherfucking time, honey. Wait, where's it at? Oh, here you go. And this should have been a single. This was off her last album. This is called So Impossible. This is from Calling All Hearts. I love baby. Shout out to Toya. We used to blast this going to the city. I was Sister Battison here, but it's all good. For love, see my heart. My heart just wouldn't let me walk away. This is number four, you guys. I knew everything was okay. There's no reason why. Oh, I love this song. Hey, remember, you guys, we are counting down my top five favorite Keisha Cole songs of all time. Number five was I Remember. Number four was So Impossible. Here's number three. Wait, no. Yeah, number three, right? Number three. Oh, I love this right. No. Woo! Keisha! Come on. This was off our first album, The Way It Is. Yes. You're telling me it's good, but it ain't not. Woo!
she want you more. Can't please easy. Best of me. My love. Don't forget, you guys, Keisha Cole's new album, Woman to Woman, will be out later this year. I wish this album would have came out, like, August. Like, do you not realize Keisha Cole? I mean, people's yearning for this album. If they're after hearing a single with you and Lil Wayne, baby, you need to push that album up. All right, so number 5 was I Remember. Number 4 was So Impossible. Number 3 was Never. Here are my top 2 favorite Keisha Cole songs of all time. Here's number 2, you guys. I love this song. Keisha Cole, Dog Chow, let's go.
Just to think about it, I would do things that I would regret.
Trying to get you to
understand how I felt for you. I tried a hard time and time again,
but I
didn't know my love wouldn't grow. I should have just let it go,
but I stay around. You're the wrong world, and we both know. Would you talk to me? I love you deep in my heart and all. Yes, baby. Yes, baby, honey. All right, now, here's my, that was Shoulda Let You Go featuring Amina. Hey, Keisha, what happened to Amina, honey? Whatever happened to your sisters? Where they at? Where's, what's homegirl name? Neffy. I miss her. Where's she at? And here's my number one favorite Keisha Cole song of all time. When I, like, Keisha, you got so many hits, girl. If I would have did the top 10, it would have been better. But I had to really break it down. And I know you all are expecting it to be Love. I love Love, but, I mean, it was, she has some better songs than that. But I love Love. But my when I think about it, my favorite Keisha Cole song of all time is off her first album. And it's this shit right here. What? Oh my god, baby. Oh my god, baby. Get it to me, baby. Get it to me. Give me some, baby. I might start crying. I love this song, Keisha. This is Down and Dirty, you all. Yes, baby. You're the type of guy to drive a girl wild. And you're the type of guy to make a girl wild. Deep down inside, people say don't get down with you, but I know how I feel for you. But I can't deny it. Yes, baby. I wanna get you. Baby, 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 I love, baby, Wonka Wonka, ew, I love that. That's my favorite Keisha Cole song of all time. Baby, you can put that song anytime. I will get up and say, I don't care where I'm at church. I don't go to church, but I'm just saying, if I was, I will get up and say out anywhere. I love that song. What is your favorite Keisha Cole song? Don't forget her new album, Woman to Woman, will be out later this year. She's a follower of mine on Twitter, so I'm pretty sure she checks in out the show. Keisha, won't you call into my show, honey? Okay, I will connect you through my Boost phone, honey, girl. All right, I'll put you on a Boost like, hey, girl. All right, I'm just going to play the beginning of her new single, Enough or No Love. Then you can check the bottom of this video. The link is on there for the full version. This is her new single. I don't know if you guys heard it yet, but this is called Enough or No Love. Girl, this up for you getting your car. Your man just made you mad, girl. Okay, you ain't supposed to drink and drive, but this song is an exception, honey. You get you a drink, girl, just drive, girl. She said, bitch.
Yes, this is new Keisha, you guys. I cannot wait for this album, man.
Cause I can't stand here.
Oh, this from you back. Sister back. Look, she back, Keisha. Look at her, I'm over her head. That's what I figure. You brought my co-host back, sister Keisha Cole. So that's Keisha Cole's new single.
Nothing, no love.
So as you can see, Keisha Cole is back, honey. Work it, bitch. Alright, you guys. So, shout out to Keisha Cole. I just love you, honey. Let's just get into some quick emails. I have an email from Angelica W.
Oh, excuse me. Damn.
She said, DL, don't tell. Anyway, she said, hello, I have a short story for you. It's about my ex. I am 8 months pregnant with his child, and I broke off the relationship because I suspected him to be on the down low. Please tell me if I was accurate.
All right, this is what she said.
Number one, she got, really, Ange, you got 25. All right, listen. She said, number one, he wore two pairs of pants in every season. In the summer, he would wear shorts under jeans or khakis. He spent every night and day with his male best friend. He wore a pink shirt on the first day we met because I told him to. I purposely dyed his white shorts pink, and he didn't notice. Wait. Okay. He wore this best male friend's poolsides on more than one. He wore this best male friend's poolsides on more than one occasion. He was cooked, cleaned, and chilled at his friend's apartment, but he's never at my house, even when we lived together for 2 months. He got defensive when I questioned his bisexuality, but insisted that I was trying to call him gay, which I never accused him of being. He walked around his friend's apartment shirtless, even though his friend and I were fully clothed. Friend became jealous when I laid my head across my ex's lap. Constantly points out happily gay rich men with fancy cars and chairs though. Did not want to see my face during sex, only my ass. Kissed me. Who's this? Sorry. Kissed me as I had cooties. Refused to perform oral sex on me. Sucked my breast like it was a dick, honey. Wanted the friend to be my daughter's godfather. Father insisted on living me and him before I was pregnant. Was scared to spank me. Loved to brag about dancing. Loved to brag about out dancing females at clubs. Basically, females be on their floor shaking their ass, and he say, "Girl, I shake my ass better than you." Use same pet names with me and his sister. Refer to women as females, but males as men, his boys, buddy, homie. Told his male friends I was wifey, but we were just dating. Made excuses to come see me, but was never tired or available, unavailable for his friends. Ate in public ate, you know, I ain't go to college, I'm retarded. Anyway, ate in public several times with his friend, but never had a date with me, not even a first date. Invited friends to movies with us without my consent. Doesn't call me nor supported me throughout my pregnancy. Tell the summary of it all. In my own point, baby, you done said it all, honey. I ain't gotta say nothing, baby. I ain't gotta say jack shit, honey. You got it all in point. Your man is hoo-hoo, shades down. I think she just wanted to vent because she didn't really have an actual question for me. Baby, that's why I try to tell you females about these down low men. All the signs are in your face. And she got it. She put them all. She probably was drying them down every night. These are signs. Don't no man act like this. Don't no real man. First of all, don't no real man go to the club, dance. Okay, he's here trying to pick up females. For you to be on that floor trying to outdance females. Hello, okay? You trying to outdance. Look, Angie, can you send me a picture of him? I'm curious to know. Alright, I have another email from Koya. This is the one I was trying to get to the other day. Anyway, she said, "Hey Bimbo, I'm Kay. Love your show, huns. Well, I'm 17 and I'm starting my senior year in high school in August. My boyfriend of 2 years is older than me and is starting college this year. He has a scholarship for basketball. Dare and trust is starting to be an issue with that. I know I'm young and shouldn't be focused so much on relationships, but I love him and always been there to be his cheerleader in high school. But babe, I can't be there to fight off them hoes anymore. What should I do? I plan on attending the same college next year as well for nursing. P.S. He's a Cancer. And loving fantastic honey." Look here, Kay, real quick and simple, bitch, okay? I hope you're not going to his college to pursue nursing just off the strength of him going to that college. I hope you're really going to that college to pursue nursing, okay? You need to let him go, bitch. You are 17 years old. I guarantee you will not be with the same dude 15 years from now. Don't let me be the person to knock your little, you know, dreams of marrying this dude. But honey, when he become a basketball player, he's going to have 100 holes throwing their pussy at him trying to get him. Okay, now if he really loved you, he would let them, because there's some, honestly, I've met a few dudes, me being a tranny drag queen now, who, y'all got a wifey, you know, I want to do it, but I'm so faithful. There's quite a few dudes out there who are faithful. So I don't know, he's a Cancer, we Cancers do hold on to our peace. If he's really in love with you, you've been together for 2 years, that's been quite a long time. So we Cancers, we do love down, you know what I'm saying? Don't get me wrong, he may be cheating, girl, because I ain't say we Cancers don't cheat, because we cheat. We some hoes, honey. You think Leos are hoes? No, Cancers are hoes, too. But when we got our main piece, we love you, we nurture you, we want you by our side. I will say this because it seems like you're really in love with this dude. Continue to hold on. Continue to ride out with him. Continue to do what it is that you got people in relationships do, because you know I'll do these relationships. I will not be nobody's relationship, honey, until I'm dead. I'm sorry, I'm a hoe, okay? I'm a hoe. I got a different nigga of the week, honey, okay? A different nigga of the night. But, no, it's not like you're in love with this dude. And P.S., he's a cutie. I just looked at the picture of you two. Oh, can you send me a picture of his dick, girl? He is gorgeous. You gorgeous too, honey. Oh, I love that. But, no, continue to ride out with him. You know, see where it goes. But anyway, I got to go, honey. I gotta get ready because me and my girl Dana and Crystal, we about to go get our pina coladas from Gun Hill Road, honey. Girl. And I'm going out tonight. I got like 4 niggas to meet tonight. It's gonna be a good night. I love Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. Alright, you all. This is the Patterson, bitch. Okay, don't be living, but I wanna take your motherfucking wig off, bitch. Show these motherfuckers. We don't hide nothing on the show, bitch. Show that motherfucking hair, bitch, okay? Show that hair on there, bitch. This is her hair. She bald-headed, bitch. She bald-headed, okay? Show that motherfucking hair, bitch, okay? Trying to front. Let these motherfuckers see that wig, bitch, and that hair under it. Anyway, you all. I love you all. Thank you for checking me out. Remember, you can email me at bimbowinehouse@gmail. Alright. I got to go, honey. I got to go. All right. Walka, walka. Ew.